Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have my October favorites. I want to give a huge shout out and thank you to everyone who wished me a happy birthday. My birthday was yesterday. You guys showered me with love on Instagram, on Snapchat, here on YouTube, and I am so grateful. I know I wrote like a mushy caption on Instagram and in my last video, but you guys truly have made all of my birthdays really special. Ever since I've been on YouTube, I've felt so blessed. I've felt so much purpose. So I know I've been MIA. I know, you don't gotta tell me, but I'm back. I'm making my comeback. So today we're talking about my October favorites. October went really quickly. I know we always say that, but it really did go pretty quickly. I don't have too many products to show you compared to like my other favorites videos because I pretty much was using products that I know I love, and I just went back to like basics, back to products that are oldies but goodies. But let's go ahead and get started. The first favorite that I want to mention is an oldie but goodie, and I always talk about it, but it's the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation, and this is in the shade Rattan. It is a foundation that I have on right now. It is the foundation that I've been wearing in my last couple of videos. I just love it so much. I love this foundation because it is so long wearing. I can touch my face and it's not sticky, it's not gonna rub off on anyone. You can hug people with this, it's not going anywhere, and I just love that it's so full coverage. And a little trick, or I guess the way that I've been applying it, is with this Makeup Forever brush. This is the 108 foundation brush. So basically what I do is I dot the foundation on my face, and then I'll go ahead and with downward motions swipe, and not really blending out, but just kind of applying the product, or kind of just spreading the product, and then I'll take my beauty blender and then really blend it in. This is going to ensure maximum coverage. I mean, this foundation is a maximum coverage kind of foundation if you want it to be, but you can also sheer it out. And I just feel like using this brush is just giving me a more even coverage. What I used to do was pour the foundation onto my beauty blender, and then I was realizing that this side of my face had more coverage because obviously this was the first place that I was applying the product. So I don't know if that makes sense, but the beauty blender was also soaking up a lot of the product. So I use less now, which I really like. So I just pour out a little bit and then I'll just dot it, or I'll just go in straight with the brush, brush it out, and then blend it out with the beauty blender. So I just love this foundation. It's my holy grail. I use it in my kits. I know a lot of people say it gives them flashback, but I feel like with this foundation, you need to make sure that you use your right shade or a pinch darker. I don't have any flashback issues. I take pictures at night and I don't get any flashback. So I use the shade Rattan. Because it is almost like a mask, you will notice if it's not your right shade. It's not one of those that's going to like conform to your skin. It's definitely just more like a paint on foundation, but I like that, especially for fall and winter. I like to be super beat. So Estee Lauder Double Wear and the Makeup Forever brush have been holy grails. The next product that I want to mention is this Clinique Chubby in the Nude Foundation Stick, and I have this in the shade Gargantuan Golden, shade number 24. It's a chubby foundation stick, and I've been using this to cream contour, or basically to like cream bronze, because it's not really a contour shade. It's definitely more on the warm side, but you guys know I love that. So I just basically create two little stripes, boom, boom, and around the perimeter of my face. And then what I'll do is I'll take this brush, which Angie put me onto this. This is the MAC 197 SH, so it's the short handle version of the 197. And it's a dual fiber flat brush. And I'll just flick the product up. So starting at the contour, I flick up. I don't blend this way or in circular. I just flick up so that the contour goes upwards. And then it just blends out so nicely because it is a foundation shade. It just blends in seamlessly. And then what I'll do is I'll take my beauty blender and then go right over that spot. And it just looks so bronzy so quick. I feel like it's so much faster to do that and then just set it with my bronzer, which you guys know Bobbi Brown Golden Light is my thing. Like, it's my jam for the contour area. So after I've blended that out, I'll just kind of set it with a bronzer, and I use the Zoeva Luxe contour brush. You guys have been watching me use this on Snapchat and you're always like, what brush is that? This is the brush that I use to contour. It has this indent. It looks like it came broken or chopped off, but it's purposely designed like that because it just cups the cheekbone really nicely and it gives you a really nice contour, a nice sharp contour if you're into that. I like it also for the perimeters of my face. I use this every single time I do my makeup. It's the Luxe contour. So I'll use Bobbi Brown Golden Light right on top to set this product, and because it is a foundation, it is very long wearing. I haven't tried the actual contour stick that Clinique makes, but I like this, and I know Renny Vasquez uses this on his models and it's really good. So try it out if you haven't. It's not too expensive. I think it's like $27 and you get a lot of product, and I just love that it's a chubby stick. It's very travel friendly as well. You don't have to bring like a contour palette with you. You can throw this in your makeup bag, and this little brush is very handy. So Love those two. Next up is another brush. I've been loving brushes lately. This is a Smith 230 brush, and it is a small goat hair brush. And I really like this one because it fits right into the crease, and it just gives me a lot of precision. I love this brush because it's not as soft as a 221. It is extremely soft, but it's not as soft, which I feel like is why I love it so much, because it really just gets in the crease but blends it out. It just has like a couple of different stray hairs kind of poking out, and it just really blends things out, and you can just use it on its side, pointed. I love it. And I read somewhere that you can use this tip to like scoop out foundation because it's antimicrobial or something. I don't know, but I read that you can use this to like do the dots on your face of foundation, so I thought that was pretty cool. And I love the long handle, so shout out to the Smith 230. This has been my jam lately. And then an eyeshadow that I've been loving, which is the eyeshadow that I have on right now on my lids. I did a little Snapchat makeup thing and you guys were going crazy about what was on my lids. It's this golden glitter cream shadow. This is from Butter London and it is in the shade Spark. So I did a vlog and I swatched it and I was like talking about how amazing it looks. So it's this jelly consistency, super weird, something like I've never tried before because it's an actual jelly. It's so fun to touch and play with. The color is so gorgeous. It's this bronzy gold color, but I love that this has like this overlay of glitter, because when I'm taking videos with flash, you can just see the glitter kind of peeking through. So it has like a base color and then the glitter on top. And what I like to do is really like further blend it out so that the glitter particles go higher, so that when I'm looking down, you see just like a little bit of random glitter on my crease area. I don't know, I just think it looks really pretty, and it's awesome. It dries really fast, like it's already dried, and it lasts really long. You guys know I've been struggling with eyelash glue problems and just eyeliner problems, but this hasn't given me any sensitivities. It is a wet product, so you just wanna work quickly. You can use your finger or you can use a brush, but the product is just insane. I love the shade. It's just so pretty, and it just looks so, so festive on the eyes. It's really gorgeous. Next, I wanna talk about Embry Lease. I've been talking about this a lot lately. This is my new tube. If you watched my last vlog, I talked about it there. This is their classic moisturizer plus primer. I'm obsessed with this. I use this every single time I do a client's makeup. I actually use the Makeup Forever brush to apply it. I just think it soaks into the skin really well. And then whatever product is left on the brush will kind of work with the foundation. So it kind of leaves a little moisture on the brush, which I like. And this is just awesome. Like, I don't know what else to say, but it's for all skin types. It doesn't break me out. It's just a good moisturizer plus primer. If I forget to put my primer on, I know I'm good, because this just, it creates a really nice barrier between your foundation and your face. It just helps it stick. It helps it go on so smooth, and I highly suggest this, especially if you're a makeup artist. I highly, highly suggest it, but even just for personal use, I think it's great. So Embry Lease, it's bomb. Next is the blush that I've been using and abusing. You guys have also been asking me on Snapchat, like, what is the blush that you have on? And it's this Charlotte Tilbury Chic to Chic Swish and Pop Blusher in Love Glow. And I have the other one, which I forgot already what it's called, but I put it away because I liked the formula. I just wasn't crazy about the color because it was very nude. It wasn't showing up too much. So once I got this one in my life, I was like, whoa, where has it been my whole life? Yes, I've said it before, I'll say it again, it looks like a nipple, yes. But this blush is so amazing. I have it on right now. It's, again, Love Glow. It's the perfect rosy color. I think this color is amazing for fall. It's not swatching well. On the face, it looks more of like a berry pink. On here, it just looks like a regular pink. It has two blush colors, and then you swirl them together to create the perfect mix of colors, because when you blush and when you flush naturally, it's not just one pigment. It's usually like a mix of two. So I like that it has like a lighter and a darker color. You can just use one. It would be kind of hard to just use one, so I just swirl it and apply, and I'm obsessed. This is probably my favorite blush formula because it's pigmented, but it's not chalky, it's not dry. The Tom Ford one can be a little dry on me. I'm not crazy about it anymore. It's not as pigmented as a MAC blush, but I like that because then you're not gonna end up with clown cheeks, although I do like to go overboard with the blush. But this one lasts so long that I don't have to go so crazy with my blush because it's gonna last all day, so I appreciate that. Next, let's talk about highlights. I have two highlights to show you. One is actually an eyeshadow, but this one is a highlight. This is the Lancome Glow Subtle Silky Cream Highlighter in Gold Lights. It's what I have on right now. I actually have both of them combined, of course. And this one is like the main attraction. Whenever I wear this on Snapchat, you guys are always screenshotting it because it's stunning. I know everyone was comparing this to the ColourPop highlights, but I just like this one so much better because it's just so silky, like the name suggests. It's very silky, and this color is just so gold and reflective. So you can use your finger to apply it, but I've been using a brush, and I use this brush from Morphe. This is the Morphe M501. I kind of got over my Morphe M310 fan brush. I know, crazy. It's shocking because I used that for so long, but I've been liking brushes like this because they're just a little more precise, and the way I apply my highlight is I kind of just brush downwards rather than a fan, which just kind of disperses a lot of product everywhere. I just focus it where I want it to glow. So I just like that this is a little more precise. This product works well with the fingers, with the beauty blender, with the brush, synthetic, goat hair, any type of brush. I just love this. It's very gold. It's very pigmented. It looks like the Kiko 208, but in a cream formula. But the best part about this is that it doesn't accentuate my bumps. A lot of cream highlights will just kind of like just get really dry and creasy and crepey and weird in that area, and they'll just show all of the texture that I have, and this doesn't do that. So I appreciate that it's so silky because I don't want any texture on my face to be highlighted, and that happens a lot with highlights. I know a lot of highlights can look so great on Instagram, but the true test is in person. I don't want to see little bumps on my face. Like, I want it to look silky and smooth and glowy and like kind of like subtle glow, but still bam when you take a picture. Does that make sense? I hope that makes sense. But this has been my jam. If you haven't tried it, check it out. VIB Rouge 20% off is coming this week, so I'll probably do an Instagram post on like what's in my cart for the Sephora VIB sales, so be on the lookout for that, or maybe on Snapchat. And the next highlight that I want to mention is not a highlight, it's a eyeshadow from MAC, and this is the In Extra Dimension eyeshadow in Sweet Heat. This looks so beautiful on tan, medium, and deep dark skin. Oh my god, it's so gorgeous. Like, I wear this when I'm not really supposed to because it is a little dark for me for a highlight, but I still wear it because I think the color is stunning. And it's like a rose color, it's almost like a rose gold, but it's so reflective that you can barely see it. But the reason why I say it's too dark for me is because highlights for my skin tone should be like champagne-y or like pearl, because this is darker than my skin tone, but I still wear it. Like, I have it on right now, and it just doesn't look good on the nose highlight because it will look like, you know, a smudge of bronze, golden, bronzy, weird rosiness on the tip of the nose. It doesn't look that good. But if you have medium or deep skin, you need this. Like, you need this yesterday. I'm telling you, you're gonna fall in love. I have nothing like this. I love it so much. Actually, I do. Like, it's kind of like Riviera from Anastasia, but just 10 times better. Like, I just love this so much. So, Sweet Heat, this is like the second one that I bought. I buy them online because usually they don't have them in store. So check it out, MAC Sweet Heat. It's an eyeshadow. It's probably an amazing eyeshadow. I haven't even used it as an eyeshadow, but I keep it in my highlight drawer because I use it as a highlight. It's amazing. Get on it. It's really good. The next product is a random one. I haven't mentioned a nail polish in a really long time. This is the Zoya nail polish in the shade Dot. So this is what it looks like. I like that this color makes my hands look really feminine and clean and just girly. I have 3 coats on right now. I get my nails done at a salon. I don't do it myself. I have a little nick here because I couldn't wait for it to dry, but I just like that it doesn't make my hands look shorter because I do have really short hands. So I like this polish, and the best thing about it is that it lasts so long. So at the salon that I go to, they use the Zoya base coat and top coat. So I don't know if that kind of has something to do with it, but I've actually used Setch Beat on top. Like, I've brought my Setch Beats and I've used that, but I think it's just the polish itself that lasts so long. Like, I can go 5, 6, 7 days minimal chipping, which is very strange for me because my nails are so brittle and weak that nail polish doesn't want to stick to them. It doesn't stay on. They're like paper thin because of all the gel that I've done and acrylics and all the drama that I put my nails through. So I'm trying to give my nails a break. I've been using strengthening base coats. I think I'm going to start putting like garlic on my nails because I need these babies to get stronger. Not longer, but just stronger. So anyway, I like this color and I think it's really pretty and girly and feminine. So I dig that. And then the next favorite is actually kind of like a newer product to me, but this is the L'Occitane Cream. It's their Ultra Rich Cream Body Butter, and it's 25% shea butter. It just looks like this. It's a tub of whipped body butter. So I actually went in to change the Josie Maran Drip, I think it's called Dripped Argan Oil Body Butter. It was really expensive and they barely gave you any product, and it wasn't moisturizing at all, and it smelled like diapers. So I didn't like that, so I changed it for this one, and I really have been enjoying it. It actually makes me feel moisturized, but it soaks in, but it still leaves a little bit of moisture on my skin. And now that we're getting into the colder times, mama needs some moisture because I'm a dry crocodile. Like, I can already tell my skin is needing a little more moisture, but this has been good to me so far, and the scent doesn't bother me, so I'm happy about that. And then the last two favorites of mine are my perfumes. Did I mention these are my last favorites? I hope I didn't, but if I did, sorry. I've still been loving these two. This is the Dahlia Divine from Givenchy or Dahlia Divine. I love it. I have the small version. I want to get the big one, but I love that I could throw this in my purse. This just makes me feel so sophisticated and sexy and just classy. I really love this one because it makes me feel classy. And then this one is the Zara Joyful Tuberose. This one just makes me feel more like sensual and like sweet and sexy, where this one's just like, bam, I'm here. Come and take me, where this one is just like, hi. I don't know. I like both. They're both really nice. This one almost smells like cologne to me, but it's a rose scent, but it almost smells like cologne, like men's cologne, and I really enjoy it. It's just, it's so good. I can just eat myself up with these two. So check those out if you haven't. And I just want to mention what's on my lips. I'm wearing Smashbox Always On Liquid Lipstick in Misconduct, because I know someone's going to ask. And they're probably still gonna ask, even though I'm saying it in this video, but I'm wearing Misconduct. I love the Smashbox formulas, but for some reason, this shade, I have to kind of work with it a little bit more. Like, I had to do like two layers, and it was a little bit harder. I love the Smashbox liquid lipsticks. They're one of my favorites, like the nude one, the gray one. Love the red, love it. But this one, for some reason, was going on a little bit streaky for me. It's the second time I wear it, but I wore this when I was at Hunter Mountain, and a lot of people were asking me what I was wearing. It was this Smashbox Misconduct. So now let's get on to my favorite parts, the music favorites. I have quite a few songs, and just because I mention a song in my favorites doesn't mean it's a new song. Some of these songs are old. I've just been enjoying them this month, so let's get on to it. You ain't the girl that you used to be. You say you're done, you're moving on. Looks like you want, looks like you want. Sick of leaving messages on yourself. A true lover, but when you're not there.
We don't remember. Do you miss me like I miss you? Fucked around and got attached to you. Friends can break your heart too. And I'm always tired, but never of you. If I pulled a U on you, you wouldn't like that shit. I put this shit on the low. You're still in love with me, but your friends don't know. I just miss you on my arm.
Timmy, Timmy, Timmy Turner. Think we're wishing for a bird. You can't hear anybody running.
Concludes this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will see you in the next one. Bye guys!